Greetings to one and all present here. Today, I, Sakshi, a BDS second year student from Manav Rachna Dental College, Faridabad, is here to present my topic, the unexplored diagnostic aid in the Indian Armed Forces, forensic odontology. Next slide, please. Forensic odontology is the branch of dental science which deals with the handling of forensic evidence for presenting it in the court of law. Military personnel are exposed to a wide range of adversities during their course of service, ranging from natural calamities to wars and anti-terrorism operations. Identification of our army men in such cases is thus imperative. Teeth endure post-mortem degradation and extreme changes in ambient temperature and pressure better than any other human tissues. And it is thus of great help to establish the identity of not only our army men, but also of terrorists escaping in disguise. In disasters such as aircraft wrecks, natural calamities, forensic odontology can be of a great succor by establishing the disaster victim identification. The picture on the right-hand side is of the fire of Bazaar de la Chat in 1897 in Paris, which was the first place where mass forensic identification by dentition was done. Next slide, please. Use of forensic in international military. Forensic odontology is used by militaries worldwide. US military has been historically involved in the DVI activities at disaster scene, identification and repatriation services through their US Armed Forces Institute of Oral Pathology. Malaysian Armed Forces also deployed their dental officers for identification of casualties from the Highland Tower condominium disaster and Malaysian Airlines Fokker 50 air crash. Canadian forces also deployed their men for DVI operations, including Swiss Air 111 air crash and in an humanitarian effort in 2010 Hayati earthquake. Identification methods used by Indian Armed Forces. Indian Armed Forces have an active participation in helping our country from a lot of crisis situations apart from their regular military work. The techniques used currently for identification include dog tags, regular autopsy, or mustering. The picture on the left-hand side is of a typical dog tag. Dog tags, previous slide, ma'am, slide back. Dog tags are made up of stainless steel. These are rectangular tabs which have information such as name, service number, blood type, and religious preference of the personnel serving. Autopsy is a surgical procedure that consists of a thorough examination of a corpse by dissection to determine cause, mode, and manner of the death for evaluation purposes. And mustering is assembling of troops for inspection purposes and counting them per head. Next slide. Now, what can be the upcoming methods which can be deployed under the forensic odontology? The first method would be orthopantomogram. Orthopantomogram of every armed forces personnel should be recorded and updated regularly. In remote areas where OPG isn't possible, a full mouth intraoral periapical radiograph should be taken, arranged in the form of OPG, and kept to form a digitized dental database. The picture on the left-hand side shows three typical radiographs. Next slide, please. The second method would be impression of dental arches. Impressions should be taken and cast prepared and preserved for an anti-mortem database. The same methodology can be followed for structuring a post-mortem profile. The comparison of anti-mortem and post-mortem profile will then just be a simple procedure. Setting up of laboratories will be the third method that I would recommend. A complete overhaul of our dental record keeping process in the laboratory will be an absolute essential phenomenon with respect to various stages of soldiers' routine service schedule that would include its, his or her recruitment and occurrence of different dental morbidities or transfer to specific locations or including them in anti-terrorism operations. Now, DNA analysis of incinerated personnel. The high temperatures of gasoline fire incinerate the body precluding the DNA analysis from the conventional site. However, most of the teeth will survive the conflagration, and thus the dental pulse can be used to extract the genomic DNA, which is a source of high molecular weight genomic DNA. The following picture shows a step-by-step procedure for extraction of DNA from a tooth. First picture shows the endodontic access cavity, which is made by a high-speed handpiece. The second picture shows a tooth after an endodontic access cavity has been made. In the third picture, the pulp is extirpated from the tooth using a barbed brooch. And the fourth picture is of a pulp sample, which was stored in phosphate buffer at 30 degrees Celsius. I would like to conclude by saying that dental officers of the armed forces can play a pivotal role in victim identification, not only during war, but also during flood relief, aircraft accidents, mass casualty during fire disasters, etc. They can be a ready-made, straightforward, and competent team members of any such relief force can be deployed and activated at the shortest possible notice, react in the most proficient manner, understand the power of command and control, and will be able to follow the code of conduct. Further, a dedicated forensic odontology laboratory will be an asset not only for the armed forces, but also inspired curious minds in the whole of the dental community. Next slide, please. These are the references that I have used for my presentation. And thank you.